Sexual dimorphism and sex roles. The relationship between sexual dimorphism and sex roles among hominids is based in a distant evolutionary beginning. The most basic reason for this relationship is the fact that females give birth to and breastfeed young, whereas males cannot physically do this. An argument for the existence of sexual dimorphism is the competition between males to secure a genetic line, whereas females are assured of passing on their genetic material every time. There is also speculation that sex roles have created sexual dimorphism. The genetic and physical basis for the segregation of the sexes at a fundamental level does not explain a culturally enforced sex roles or gender roles. While there is a definite link between sexual dimorphism and basic sex role functions such as breastfeeding for early hominoids, there is no strong connection for sexual dimorphism and sex roles or gender roles in humans. Humans have used culture to surpass the need of biology. For example, the woman does not need to be the primary caregiver or gatherer, and the man does not necessarily have to be the hunter or protector. The basic sexual differences and functions of male and female hominoids may have caused initial differences in sex roles, but would not have created the present-day gender roles constructed primarily by culture. In the female animal, Elia lists numerous possibilities as to why sexual dimorphism arose within hominoids, including early maturation of females and thus earlier and longer reproductive cycles. This may be an explanation for the presence of sexual dimorphism with humankind's early ancestors, and consequently in most present-day hominoids. The early maturation of females would mean that females who naturally matured earlier would be sexually selected, thus passing on a genetic material for this trait. Eventually, all females would be maturing at an earlier age, and thus would be smaller due to this early maturation. Males would need to be large to compete with each other for the chance to mate with a female and thus pass on their genetic material. Traits such as aggression and physically larger size would then be selected for by default. So, most hominoid females would be smaller and most hominoid males would be larger. Due to this difference in female and male physique, it may have been more convenient for the two sexes to assume their assorted gender roles, thus creating the basis for the sex roles present today. Another possible explanation for the evolution of sex roles and sexual dimorphism is that sex roles created sexual dimorphism. That is, man's role as a hunter predisposed him to stronger muscles and a larger build, and woman's role as caretaker predisposed her to a smaller frame. This explanation of the reversed order of appearance of roles and form, however, does not justify or explain the existence of current gender roles such as public man, private woman, where women do the majority of unpaid or private work, or the assumption that males are better equipped to handle certain situations such as politics. As Epstein puts it, no one disputes that males and females possess different reproductive biological organs and secondary sexual characteristics, but there is considerable debate as to whether they have different basic emotional and cognitive attributes as well. Gross points out that sex roles and sexual dimorphism show no signs of being connected when studied in the closest 8 relatives to humans. This means, after taking away the constraints of human culture, a direct connection between sexual dimorphism and sex roles still cannot be seen. Therefore, it is highly unlikely that they are related in any real sense. Or, to put it another way, the physical differences between the sexes do not account for the social differences. So, in conclusion, while it is difficult to prove whether sex roles created sexual dimorphism or if sex roles were a natural adaptation stemming from a need to survive, it is obvious that sex roles did not arise purely from sexual dimorphism. As stated earlier, it has been shown that there is no direct connection between sexual dimorphism and sex roles with apes, and using these hominoids for a culturally free comparison, it is highly possible that sexual dimorphism holds no strong relationship to sex roles for humans either. Even if there was a connection between sexual dimorphism and sex roles for humans in the distant past, there is no reason now to continue this connection. The differing secondary sex traits between male and female humans are becoming less pronounced, as well as having been made almost redundant by technology. For present-day humans, any disadvantages encountered by our sexually dimorphic species can now be resolved by applying our advanced intelligence and flexible culture to the problem. Therefore, by considering the previous information, it is quite clear that sex roles and sexual dimorphism are not strongly connected for either apes or humans.